Hey guys, so this is an example video of what to do with systems of equations when you've got three equations. And I've already done a lesson video on this, so I'm assuming that you kind of know the basics, but you just want to see more examples. And in this video, I'm going to go through these three examples, and they're all pretty different actually. So A is going to be kind of more like the standard example that I talked about in my lesson video. This one is three equations, but each equation is like missing a variable. And then this last one is going to have kind of a strange path to get to the answer. So I think this is a good breadth of problems. And if there's a specific one you want to see, you can always fast forward to it. Or you could always use this as a great way to quiz yourself. And then you can check out the solutions as I go through them. Okay, so let's get going. So I'm just going to jump right into this. Like I said, I'm assuming that you already kind of know the basics. If you don't and you want to see a total breakdown of all the steps, I highly recommend you go to the lesson video, and I'll drop a link in the description. Okay, so for this one, to start, I'm going to just label my three equations. And as I look through the problem set, I notice that I could pretty easily eliminate these x's here. So I like to start with the path of least resistance, so I will start there. So first I'm just going to rewrite out the equations so that I can effectively eliminate. So let's see, we'll rewrite both of these. And now we can eliminate. So if I just add straight down, my x's drop out. I'm left with 6y minus 3z equals 3. And I'm going to call this my equation A. Okay. So let me erase this now, and just going forward, I think what I'll use is I'll use equation 2 to then eliminate the x out of equation 3, because you have to eliminate the same variable up to 2 times. Okay, so let me make some space. And now what I want to do is, so that I can effectively eliminate my x's, I'm going to need to multiply the second equation by 2. So I'll go ahead and just note that. I'm going to multiply by 2 when I write this out. So here's my second equation multiplied by 2. So this becomes negative 2x plus 6y minus 4z equals 10. And then I can write down the third equation. So this is just 2x plus 4y plus 2z equals 4. Okay, and so now once again I can eliminate. So I can just add everything straight down. So my x's will drop out. I'm left with 10y minus 2z equals 14. And so this is my other equation. So let me make some space. And now this is, let me see, I'll get rid of all of this stuff over here too. This is really the goal, right? Your goal is to get to a system that has just two equations and two variables. So now that I have this, I can really use whatever techniques I want to solve for the system. So in looking at this, elimination would require me to multiply both equations by a number, or I could use substitution, it doesn't matter. I usually prefer elimination. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna multiply this first equation. I'm gonna multiply it by negative 2 so that this will become positive 6. And then I'm gonna multiply this equation by 3. So let's see, I'll just note that, multiply by 3. And I like writing all these notes out because it helps me stay organized, and it helps me not forget what my plan was. I always joke that I have like the memory of a hamster. It's not a joke though, it's true. Okay, so now I have these two equations. So negative 12y plus 6z equals negative 6, and then 30y minus 6z equals 42. So now if I combine these, I get 18y equals 36. And if I divide both sides by 36, I'm gonna get that y equals 2. So I've got my first solution, y equals 2, so I'll just note it over there. And so now I can plug this back into one of these two equations to figure out what my z is. So I'll plug this into the first equation. So this becomes 6 times 2 minus 3z equals 3. So that's 12 minus 3z equals 3. I can subtract off the 12 to get negative 3z equals negative 9. And then I can divide both sides by negative 3. So ultimately I get that z equals 3 in this case. So now that I have these two solutions, I go back to the original system and I can choose any equation that I want to plug these two solutions in so that I can solve for x. So let me clear space. And now, let's see, I will plug these into the first equation. How about that? So I've got x plus 3 times 2 minus 3 equals negative 2. So this is x plus 6 minus 3 equals negative 2. So this becomes x plus 3 equals negative 2. I can subtract the 3 from each side to get x equals negative 5. And so there's my solution. And so my ordered pair is negative 5, 2, and 3. And then you'll just want to check that by plugging this into each one of these equations. Okay, so moving on to the next example. So now I've got the three equations, and they each seem to be like missing a variable. So it's a very similar approach in that we still want to like kind of think of these three equations. And we look for what looks like it will be the easiest to eliminate. So to me, as I look through these equations, I see this x and this minus x, so I could eliminate the x's, or I've got negative 2z and 2z, so the z's would also be easy to cancel out. So it really doesn't matter which one you want to choose. I'm just going to choose the z's. So if I do that, let's see, I'll go ahead and write out the two equations. And okay. So now I can go ahead and eliminate my z's. So as I kind of add down here, so notice I've got this x and this minus 4y, but my z's drop out, and then if I add 2 minus 2, that's 0. So here's the equation that I'm left with, and I'm going to label this with an A. But the thing that I want you to notice now is that I am left with an equation in terms of x and y, and the third equation, so the equation that I haven't touched yet, is actually already in terms of x and y. So this is kind of the twist that comes with having three equations, but they're missing variables. When this happens, you don't need to eliminate again. You can just take this equation with this one that you've already made. So let me clear some space. And now let me write these two equations side by side. So I've got x minus 4y equals 0, and negative x plus 3y equals negative 3. So I can go ahead now and just treat this like a normal system. And actually, this one is already set up to do elimination. So I can go ahead and just eliminate. So in doing that, what I'm left with, negative y equals negative 3, which means then that y equals 3. So you can see that when you're missing variables, this is actually a much quicker process. So I'll go ahead and note that solution here. And then I can solve for x by plugging this in to one of these two equations. Doesn't matter which one. So I just treat this like a normal system now. So I'm going to plug this into the first equation. So I'll call this x minus 4 times 3 equals 0. So this will be x minus 12 equals 0. So if I add the 12 to both sides, I get that x equals 12. And now I can plug either one of these solutions back into one of these equations as long as it's got a z, because that's really the last thing that I need to solve for. So let me clear some space. And I'm going to plug this into the first equation. I've got this z here. So this will become 12 minus 2z equals 2. So I've really just got 12 minus 2z equals 2. So I can subtract the 12. So let's just say equals. So now I've got negative 2z equals negative 10. Divide both sides by negative 2 to get z equals positive 5. And so my ordered pair then would be 12, 3, and 5. And so that would be it. And once again, you can plug this solution back into the three equations, which you should do to make sure that it works. Okay, so now for the last one. So what we're going to do for this one is we're going to just start by eliminating. And in this case, let's see, it looks to me like I could pretty easily eliminate really my x's or my y's or my z's. It doesn't really seem to matter which letter you choose. So maybe you want to pause here and try to eliminate on your own and see what you get. Okay, so I'm going to start by taking the first equation and the second equation, and I'm going to multiply, let's see, I'll multiply the first equation by negative 3. Okay, so if I do that, this will become negative 3x plus 12y minus 6z equals 21. And then 3x minus 8y plus z equals 7. So if I go through and start this, this is going to give me 4y minus 5z equals 28. Okay, so far so good. So I'm just going to clear some space and note this equation. Okay, so first I used equations 1 and 2. So now I'm going to use equations 1 and 3. And since I was eliminating the x's, what I'm going to have to do in this case is I'm going to have to multiply by negative 6. So this will become negative 6x plus 12y minus 12z equals positive 42. And then I have the third equation, so this is 6x minus 12y plus 3z equals 12. Okay, so if I try to eliminate in this case, now what I see happening is my x's dropped out and my y's dropped out, but I'm left with negative 9z equals 54. And if I divide both sides by 9 there, I'm going to get that z actually would just equal negative 6. Now, this is a bit of an unusual result, I realize. And this should have been really what was like our B equation. So now we have to kind of take inventory of what do we have? How do we interpret this? So notice I've got z equals negative 6. This equation did not result in like another letter. So that's okay. Actually, I can take this z equals negative 6 and I can plug it back into this other equation that I made with just the two variables. So I can kind of slowly work my way back through all these letters now. So slightly different way of kind of approaching this problem, but we'll still get there. So let me make some space. Okay, so I'm going to plug this into my A equation. So this becomes 4y minus 5 times negative 6 equals 28. So this becomes 4y plus 30 equals 28. You can subtract off the 30. And I get 4y equals negative 2, which if I divide both sides by 4, y will ultimately come out to negative 1 half. Okay, so now I've got z and I've got y. So now I can plug these two back into any one of these just to solve for x, right? So now let me erase what I've got. And let's finish this. So I'm going to plug these results then into this equation C. So this becomes x minus 4 times negative 1 half plus 2 times negative 6 equals negative 6, or sorry, equals negative 7. Okay, so let's work this out. So this becomes x, so half of 4 will just be 2. So this becomes x plus 2, because the negatives cancel out, minus 12 equals negative 7. So I get x minus 10 equals negative 7. And then I can add 10 to both sides to get that x equals 3. And so there's my final solution. So the ordered pair in this case is going to be 3, negative 1 half, and negative 6. So, you know, try not to get too freaked out, I guess, if you end up kind of losing all your letters and solve for one of these values. That's okay. You can kind of just keep working your way through, especially if you end up having this type of situation where, you know, I found z, so I could, you know, back into what y would be. You can totally work it like that, and that works out. And so that's everything that I've got for this video, guys. If you have any questions or if you want to see more examples, you can always leave me a comment. I'm always staying on top of this channel. And if I have a request for more videos, then I'll make more.